joining us on a headset on the field is the man who is no longer the birthday boy since it's past midnight, but a happy 24th birthday to Chris Oladokun, who made his first start as a Jackrabbit here tonight and leads SDSU to its second FBS win as a Division I member as the Jacks defeat Colorado State. Chris, let's just begin with this. It's been such an interesting path you've traveled to get to this point, to be on a top five team in the FCS, to come here, to be dominant in an FBS win. Just what does it feel like for you right now?
It feels great. You know, group of guys around me, they're great guys. You know, they have my back and they know I have their back as well. So, you know, to come out here versus an FBS opponent, you know, the stadium was rocking. And before we came out, I was like, by the end, they're going to be quiet. And that stadium's going to be a lot less full than it was. And, you know, we took care of business.
This is a Colorado State team that has one of the best defensive lines it did a year ago in the FBS. They lived in the backfield. Did not have one sack tonight. And while there were times that you were able to get around some pressure, for the most part, those 605 Hawks kept your feet clean. What a job they did tonight.
Yeah, those are my guys. Those 605 Hogs up there, and, you know, they kept me clean. They promised they'd keep my white fit on. Promise that for the birthday, no sacks. So, you know, I'm definitely going to treat those guys this weekend, make sure they get some ice cream or something. But, yeah, it was a great job by them, and, you know, also by receivers too, knowing I had to get the ball out fast, you know, with a good D-line. And so I think overall, as an offense, good team effort.
I have to clarify that. They made a birthday promise there would be no sacks.
They did, and they upheld their bargain. So.
All right, well, if you're going to take them out, either dessert or a buffet, don't buy them a regular meal, Chris. You won't have enough money for the rest of the semester.
Yeah, I might go broke if I do that, but they definitely deserve something, so I'm going to get them right.
Hey, tell me about the view for you with Pierre Strong Jr. and Isaiah Davis and that 1-2 tandem at running back.
Man, it's hard to stop. You know, when we're clicking on all cylinders, you know, we just talked about the Hogs up front. You know, our receivers out wide, you know, can make special plays, and I believe I can get the ball to them at any point. But, you know, it just makes my life even that much easier, because you saw in the beginning they're trying to stack the box and, you know, stop Pierre and Isaiah, you know. And they did a fair job at the beginning, and then, you know, we sort of got rolling and pushed them off the ball. So having those two guys takes a lot of load off my back and just makes us all around, you know, great team.
It did seem like it took maybe a couple of series to really get into rhythm, but once you did, you guys kind of found what you could do and had a lot of success tonight.
Yeah, Ben, we all believed in each other. I think that was the main thing. We knew after those first two series, once we got that first score, we knew we were going to keep rolling. We just went back to stuff we've been working off all camp. You know, that two-minute drive at the end, that was beautiful. I told them, you know, we live for this right here, two-minute drive. You know, we completed a lot of them in fall camp, so it was just like practice. You know, third downs, we were good on third down today, and that's also translated from practice. So, you know, we just got to keep going, 1-0 each week.
I got to hear about that 46-yard throw to Jaden Yonke. That thing was right on the money at the end of the first half.
Yeah, we sort of knew the look we were going to get, you know, ending the half. And I told Jane, I was like, listen, man, you beat him. I trust you. And we're going to beat him one-on-one. And, you know, he ran a great route. And offensive line gave me some time. I was able to put the ball in the money, you know. I just I also feel really bad for Landon. You know, he's the hardest worker on our team. And, you know, to see him go down like that in such, like, a freak accident, I still don't even know what the injury is. But, you know, to see the emotion, you know, that he showed, I really felt for him. So, and I told him when he got hurt, we're going to do it for him. So I'm glad we were able to pull it out for him.
Chris, what was that locker room like a moment ago?
Oh, we were pumped, you know. First FBS win in, I think, 9 years, they said. So, you know, it's a great stamp, you know, especially for the seniors to leave a legacy, being an FBS team. And, you know, just got to keep this momentum going as we roll into week two.
And how excited are you to play in Brookings in 8 days?
I'm really excited. You know, I hope the Dane is packed. You know, as they saw today, we got a special team, and I think we're going to be able to put on a show. As long as we keep, you know, doing what we do. So,
Chris, congratulations. Happy birthday. Go celebrate.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
And now we are joined by Xavier Ward to discuss what this defense did tonight. And X, to come on the road, Colorado State, you knew they had a talented transfer at running back. You knew they wanted to pound away. You and your teammates, though, really established that defensive line. Tell me about the battle up front and how you guys won it this evening.
I mean, like I always tell you, the defensive line is always going to come out and be themselves, and I think that's one thing we're known for, is stopping the run, and I think we do a good job at doing that.
When you walked out here, you had the delay, you had to go back in, you've waited to get back on the field, you waited all day to play, now you have that delay. explain the balancing act of trying to stay up for the game but also handle all the emotions of having to wait and wait and wait?
Honestly, we're just in the locker room being a bunch of guys, so I mean, it's not really much of a wait. It's just more goofing around, getting ready for the game. But in all seriousness, I mean, every opponent we played, every game like this, we've been in those situations, so it's not anything the Jacks can't handle.
All right, you opened the Pandora's box, so I got to ask, were you playing games? Are you doing, like, karaoke competitions? What are you guys in the D-line doing during this delay?
A lot of laying around, a lot of yelling at each other, screaming, keeping each other hype. I mean, honestly, there's some things you can't say, but, I mean, it's always a great time.
Hey, how good is Caleb Sanders?
I love Caleb. Caleb's really good. He's got a high motor. He's got that wrestling background, so he's always good. He's always ready to move, keep going, and he can bend well.
To come on the road against an FBS team, and not just to win, but to dominate. This is an impressive statement. And you guys were confident, as you should be, that you can win a game like this. What are the emotions right now after this game, the way you played to open this season?
Honestly, I'm super excited. But, you know, we have a vision for the future, but we also have to focus on the 1-0. And honestly, we just got to take every game at a time. Honestly, I'm happy, I'm great, but now we're looking for the next opponent. And honestly, that's what we got to keep doing.
As you guys ran to the locker room once this game was final, that collection of Jackrabbit fans standing around where you're standing now all came down. You guys went over. There were handshakes. There were hugs. Had to be a very special moment.
No, honestly, I love seeing traveling Jacks. I mean, it just shows the dedication our community has around the Jackrabbit football team. So honestly, I just want to thank everyone. Thank all of them for coming because they make it fun. I mean, whenever you make a play and you can look over and see a big group of blue, and they're cheering for you and have your back. I mean, that just goes to show what kind of community we have.
X, last question. How excited are you to be back at home next Saturday?
Oh, I'm ready to play in the Dana J. I've been waiting for it for a while. Even though it's a short turnaround, still feels like forever. Honestly, I'm really excited.